Good evening. Welcome to the graduation ceremony of the St. Stanislaus Catholic School, Class of 2020. We are excited to recognize this amazing group of young men and women for their many achievements and for overcoming the challenges they faced this year. Before we begin, please take a moment to silence your cell phones and remember to keep your social distance while in the church. It is a great honor for me to welcome all of you, our assembled guests, our graduates, our parents, and teachers of St. Stanislaus Catholic School Class of 2020. I'm pleased to be a part of the graduation celebration for these extraordinary students. Some of these students have been at St. Stanislaus since preschool, and others have joined our community over the years. However, each and every one of these graduates has been an integral part of the Class of 2020. So today, on the solemnity of the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, we praise God for his mercy and love, and we thank him for the lives of these students. Class of 2020, this is your long-awaited and well-deserved ceremony to honor and recognize all your accomplishments. Give him a hand, please. And now I'd like to introduce Deacon Jose Reyes.
It's only 25 pages long, so don't worry about it. Thank you, Mrs. Holcraft. It is truly a blessing to be here with all of you tonight. A few weeks ago, we were thinking that this was going to be a virtual graduation, with all the school staff, priest, and myself driving many cars for a drive-by congratulations to each of your homes. We were gonna show up in your homes unannounced. Thanks be to God, we didn't have to do that. Instead, here we are, gathered as a church, in the presence of Jesus Christ, who is present here in four different ways. Jesus is present in the Blessed Sacrament. Jesus is present in Father Miriam, whom when he presides Mass, he does it in persona Christi, that is, in the person of Christ. Jesus is present among us as a community that gathers in his name, because he said it, when two or three are gathered in my name, I am there. And last but not least, Jesus is present in the proclamation of the word, which we will do in very few minutes. I hope that you who are graduating this year, your future is not defined by the events of this year, especially the COVID-19 pandemic, but rather your future will be defined by the core values that have been instilled in you during your time at St. Stanislaus School and the parish community. Just as we gather in this 107 years old building, it is the tradition of St. Stanislaus that keeps us connected with those who founded our community over 140 years ago. It is by living the traditions of the school that you will be building a strong and positive future. You are part of our community. As a member of this community, you have grown in your faith, which is part of who you are as an individual. Do not let the turmoil of the society diminish your faith. Stand by what you believe. Remember the words we will hear in the second reading today. God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. For the rest of your lives, strive to achieve excellence in everything you do, and may that excellence be manifest in the integrity of your life. Congratulations, class of 2020. Thank you. We will begin now the liturgy of the word, which is the ceremony or the liturgy by which we proclaim the word of God, and Father Miriam will be presiding that liturgy. So I'm going to have you to hold on a second. Don't read yet.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who glory in the heart of your beloved Son, and recall the wonders of his love for us, may we be made worthy to receive an overflowing measure of grace from that fount of heavenly gifts, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. And now you may be seated for the word of God.
A reading from Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "You are a people based sacred to the Lord your God. He has chosen you from all the nations on the face of the earth to be a people peculiarly his own. It was not because you are the largest of all nations that the Lord set his heart on you and chose you, for you are really the smallest of all nations. It was because the Lord loved you and because of his fidelity to the oath that he had sworn to your fathers, that he brought you out with his strong hand from the place of slavery and ransomed you from the hand of the Pharaoh, king of Egypt. Understand then that the Lord your God is God indeed, the faithful God who keeps his merciful covenant down to the thousandth generation toward those who love him and keep his commandments, but who repays with destruction a person who hates him. He does not dally with such a one, but makes them personally pay for it. You shall therefore carefully observe these commandments, the statutes, and the decrees that I enjoin on you today." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response is, "The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him." The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him. Bless the Lord, O my soul. All my being, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him. He pardons all your iniquities. He heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction, crowns you with kindness and compassion. The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him. Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our times. The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. And this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God. Yet, if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him and he in us, that he has given us of his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testify that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God, and God in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. At that time, Jesus exclaimed, "I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to little ones. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light." And this is the gospel of Jesus Christ. I failed to mention at the beginning that your graduation falls on the feast of the most sacred heart of Jesus today. During the coronavirus, I presume most of us have more time. I, for my part, probably have been watching too much TV, but I also have been reading a lot. I read 3 books on church history, and last week I finished a book on Taj Mahal. And right now, I'm reading a book on the Crusades. But I want to focus a bit on Taj Mahal. It was built in the 17th century by the emperor with the name of Jahal. He employed 22,000 workers working in various shifts, 24 hours a day, for 22 years. 22,000 workers working every day for 22 years. He used 28 precious gems aside from the white marble, there was a lot of gold and silver, which disappeared because of the various invasions. But the reason he built this palace was to honor his wife. She died, giving birth to their 14th child. And you can imagine the love that the emperor had for his wife. He did not spare anything, including his great wealth, to build a monument to his love for her. God also showed his great love for us. God the Father sent his Son into this world. And God's Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, gave his life on the cross for our sins and for our salvation. On the cross, his side was pierced with a lance, and water and blood flowed out of his side, showing us God's incredible love for us. This feast asks us this question: how do we show our love for God? An anonymous person said this: God loves us so incredibly, as if we were the only person in this world to love. God loves you too, as well. And today, we honor a big milestone in your lives. You are graduating from St. Stanislaus School. It is a time, no doubt, filled with sadness and expectation. Sadness because you are going to leave some of your friends behind, your favorite teacher, perhaps even your favorite deacon. And yet you are looking forward to your future as well, because you will embark on a new journey in your life. As you continue to do so, just remember that whatever you do or do not do, whatever you say or do not say, God loves you unconditionally. Amen.
We are now going to hear from our salutatorian and our valedictorian, our two students who achieved the highest academic honor. So first I would like to invite our salutatorian up, Benny Padilla.
Fellow classmates and parents, today is a very important day as we celebrate almost a decade of long, hard years of learning, but also our new path into high school. Today, we are all surrounded by people who have helped us on our journey, including staff members, teachers, family members, and parents. These people are heroes in everybody's lives, because without them, none of us would be where we are today. I would like to thank all my classmates for making middle school some of the most fun years of my life. I'd also like to thank all of the 8th grade basketball players for making basketball fun and helping us make a good run in the tournament. Although I'm salutatorian, this hasn't come easy. Having to switch schools 3 times and having to make friends all over again is really tough. Also, having to gain new habits and losing some that were bad. In addition, I would like to spend extra time studying and making sure that I'm mentally ready for any academic challenges that come in my way. And it may seem like a lot to study for an extra hour, but that extra hour can go a long way. At this moment in our lives, we should celebrate our 8th grade graduation, but we shouldn't forget that this isn't the end of the path. We still have many years left before schooling. During our high school time, we should try our best academically so we can open up many paths and opportunities in our lives. We should also try to have as much fun as we can because we only have 4 years of high school. We should try our best to participate in sports and other extracurricular activities because most of us won't be able to do that anymore when school ends. During this final part of my speech, I'd like to give special thanks to some people. I'd like to thank Mr. Millivong for helping all of us get good habits and always pushing us to be our best. I'd also like to thank Ms. Raspo for making everybody's year funner and always trying to do her best. I'd like to thank Ms. Alejandre for strengthening our connection with God and teaching us more about Him. I'd like to thank Ms. Munoz for always trying your best to help me out and do the best you can for me. I'd also like to wish goodbye to Sofia Martinez, Ramon Gonzalez, Ryan Trent, and Angela Machado, Addison Eberhardt, and Francisco O'Brien. Although we might never see each other again, I wish you guys the best luck. Finally, I'd like to thank my mom and dad for always pushing me to do my best and always helping me with whatever I need to succeed. Thank you.
Well done, Benny. You know, it's not easy to get up here, so I'm really proud of you for doing that. And now our valedictorian, Katie Houghton.
I don't even understand how I'm up here right now. This is just all so surreal to me. It feels like this year just started, when we were also ready to wear those 8th grade jackets, meet our kindergarten buddies, go to Washington, D.C., and of course, be the oldest in the school. When we were younger, 8th graders seemed so intimidating. We saw them as these big, amazing people and always wanted to be in their position. We wanted to be in 8th grade. I remember before and always wanted to be in their position. I remember before our 7th grade year ended, talking about how excited we all were to finally experience these things and to have those privileges. We were ready to be the people that we had dreamed of being as kids. Here we are now. We are already done with middle school. And to think that we were getting ready to become those big 8th graders at this time last year. I know for a fact, at this time last year, we had no idea that our graduation would be in the middle of June during a worldwide pandemic. But I mean, we are here and we still get to graduate all together as the class of 2020. As we all experienced, this year ended pretty abruptly. We thought that maybe we wouldn't have online classes for the rest of the school year. Personally, I thought it would only be for a few weeks, but then the situation became worse and worse. All of a sudden, at some point, I think it all hit us. We realized that we wished we could have had just one more day at St. Stanislaus. Every day, we would walk into our homeroom, often complaining about being tired or how much we didn't want to be at school. We would rant about how much work we had the night before or the test that would be taking place later that day. Some days, we would walk in weirdly energetic, which I'm sure the teachers loved. There were bad days where you felt like you couldn't even laugh when all you wanted to do was go back home. There were days where you couldn't stop laughing to the point where you got in trouble, but it didn't even matter because you couldn't contain it. There were those days when we couldn't even think hard enough to do simple math that we learned years ago, yet that was the one time Ms. Novong chose to have you go up to the board. There were days when we were embarrassed about random things and just laughed along because it helped. We shared tears together, whether at retreat or outside of school. We shared the longest laughs, biggest smiles, and the most genuine hugs. But at the end of every day, we were always one class. It didn't matter how good or bad your day went, because we all went through it together. We did it as a family, walking from class to class, turning in assignment after assignment, taking and turning in tests, to then look around the room to see everyone just as confused as you were. It was done together, as a team, in a family. After all, we do treat each other just as we would our real siblings, right? I know that I will miss spending more than half of every week with you all, even when we have all driven each other basically insane. Many of us walked in St. Stanislaus as preschoolers, excited to meet our new friends and nothing but curiosity filling our minds. Now we are walking out as eighth graders, nervous but excited to move on to high school. We should all be extremely proud of ourselves and how far we have come. Take just a second to think back on your first day of kindergarten, lining up, meeting your teacher, just so excited at the thought of all these new friends around you. Back then, it was so easy to find yourself smiling. Everything was so big and entertaining. It didn't matter who the person you were standing next to was. You only thought of them as a friend and someone to talk to. As we got older, we started to see the differences in our friends from kindergarten to now. In fact, we started seeing a lot of differences in our lives as the grades went on. The more we became aware of our responsibilities, the more difficult things became. Someone stealing your swing in second grade became the equivalent to getting a bad grade or losing that game against the school you really wanted to beat. Someone not trading the snack you wanted from them became the same as forgetting your math homework, or any homework for that matter. Recess ending became, well, actually that part still hasn't changed. Besides that, things that have changed. We have also changed. We have grown up these last 10 years together, changing through them as we grew. We have gone through everything together. Whether we believe it or not, we have all helped shape our classmates into the people who surround us today. Looking back at our times at St. Stanis, it seems that the little things seem to be the most memorable. Laughing in class, playing tag at recess, talking at lunchtime, all of it makes me smile. The things that seem like everyday life are the things that I know for sure will be missed the most. Whenever my day had gone completely downhill, I would ask myself what the best part of my day was. And thinking about it now, it would always be the smallest laugh or joke that took place earlier that day. As annoying as some days seemed at the time, this whole pandemic has allowed us to notice that we should quit taking things for granted. At some point, during quarantine, we all realized that our days became dull without the enthusiasm and craziness of our fellow classmates. We had no idea how important we all were to one another until it was taken away from us so quickly. The simple things like hugs and being close to someone seem so beautiful now. We all have taken things for granted, and I'm sure that we regret it. But little do we know that something like a hug from a friend or the loudness in a classroom would be missed so much. As we move forward, let's be thankful for all of our daily actions and the way they make us feel, because who knows what the next day could bring or take away from us. We have grown up at this school, and as we leave, we will continue to grow every single day. But our foundation will always be here, at St. Stanislaus Catholic School. St. Stanislaus has allowed us to grow and become the people that we know today. The school has given you and me some of the most important values that we possess. It's now our job to go out and share them with the world. Though we sometimes had complaints about this place along the way, I wouldn't trade these years for anything else in the world. Here, we grew in our faith, friendship, and knowledge. As we move on to the next chapter of our lives, never forget where you began and the lessons you've learned here. You will carry them with you for the rest of your life. As you move forward, never forget to look back every once in a while to remember what got you to where you are and the special place that it holds in your heart. Congratulations, class of 2020. We made it.
Please rise. Let us now present our needs and the needs of all God's people before our loving God.
The response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We thank you, Lord, for the many blessings you have given us. We pray that we will always remember that our talents are gifts from you and that it is our responsibility for us to use them so others may see Christ's light in us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We thank you, Lord, for our families, our friends, and for all those who have helped us become the young men and women we are today. We thank you for the blessing of our lives and filling it us with love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we begin this new journey in our lives, we ask you, Lord, to stay by our sides and guide us through all our endeavors. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, Lord, that our friendships and memories we had made here at St. Stanislaus Catholic School will forever be close to our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are students, athletes, musicians, and artists. We will continue to be faithful people, lifelong learners, responsible citizens, and effective communicators. We pray, Lord, that you will bless us with wisdom and creativity today and always. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that the gifts of the Holy Spirit received at the sacrament of our confirmation will always help us to be true witnesses of our Catholic faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, listen to the needs we expressed out loud and those we hold deeply within our hearts, and grant us the grace so that we will continue to love you with all our hearts, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now you may be seated.
At this time, we will be announcing the students who have earned awards and scholarships. Students, reminder, please stand up when your name is called, but you're not going to be coming forward for anything. You're just going to stand up, stay in your spot, and then sit down, okay? For the award of overall academic distinction, students are wearing a gold cord with their cap and gown. They needed to earn a 3.7 or higher cumulative GPA during both 7th and 8th grade. Please stand when your name is called. Atticus Bray, Sophia Castillon, Addison Eberhardt, Albert Gonzalez, Trace Hernandez, Katie Houghton, Grayson Hoy, Evan Lundquist, Sophia Martinez, Grace Miller, Spencer Mortensen, Francisco O'Brien, Benny Padilla, and Mia Robles. At this point, I'd like the other teachers and Mrs. Holcroft to join us. Each student is also wearing a ribbon. On those ribbons, some of the students have pins that they've earned for academic honors. If they earned straight A's in a subject matter, they were given a pin, and there were also some pins that were given for other activities, which we will also go over.
I have two classes to announce, but let's start with one of them. For language arts, we would like to recognize the following students: Atticus Bray, Sophia Castellon, Addison Eberhardt, Elise Gary, Albert Gonzalez, Trace Hernandez, Katie Houghton, Grayson Hoy, Evan Lundquist, Sophia Martinez, Grace Miller, Spencer Mortensen, Francisco O'Brien, Benny Padilla, Mia Robles, and Brent Sams. You may be seated. And for another English class, for composition and literature, we'd like to recognize the following students: Atticus Bray, Sophia Castellon, Addison Eberhard, Elise Gary, Albert Gonzalez, Harshan Graywall, Trace Hernandez, Katie Houghton, Grayson Hoy, Evan Lundquist, Sophia Martinez, Grace Miller, Spencer Mortensen, Francisco O'Brien, Benny Padilla, Mia Robles, and Genesis Rodriguez. Thank you.
And Mr. Millivong could not be here. He was really disappointed about that, but he could not be here. So I'm going to call for those for math. We would like to recognize Sophia Castellon, Addison Eberhardt, Albert Gonzalez, Trace Hernandez, Katie Houghton, Evan Lundquist, Francisco O'Brien, and Benny Padilla. And for science, we would like to recognize Sophia Castellon, Albert Gonzalez, Katie Houghton, Grayson Hoy, Spencer Mortensen, Francisco O'Brien, Benny Padilla, Mia Robles, and Brent Sams.
For religion, we would like to recognize Clarissa Alejandre, Atticus Bray, Sophia Castellon, Addison Eberhardt, Elise Gary, Albert Gonzalez, Jorge Guerrero, Trace Hernandez, Katie Houghton, Grayson Hoy, Evan Lundquist, Sophia Martinez, Grace Miller, Spencer Mortensen, Francisco O'Brien, Benicio Padilla, Mia Robles, Genesis Plasencia Rodriguez, and Brent Sams.
For social studies, we would like to recognize Atticus Bray, Sophia Castellon, Addison Eberhardt, Nico Ersig, Elise Gary, Albert Gonzalez, Jorge Guerrero, Trace Hernandez, Katie Houghton, Grayson Hoy, Evan Lundquist, Sophia Martinez, Grace Miller, Spencer Mortensen, Francisco O'Brien, Benny Padilla, Mia Robles, and Genesis Plasencia Rodriguez.
In addition to academic subject area pins, many students earn their pins for other distinctions. The Citizenship Award is earned by students having outstanding citizenship in all classes during all three trimesters of eighth grade. For distinction in citizenship, we would like to recognize Atticus Bray, Katie Houghton, Grayson Hoy, Evan Lundquist, Mia Robles, and Brent Sams.
We would also like to recognize the students for participating in St. Stanislaus Catholic School's Student Council during middle school. Please stand when your name is called. Clarissa Alejandre, William Amari, Sophia Castellon, Jackson Dykesel, Elise Gary, Albert Gonzalez, Harshan Graywall, Jorge Guerrero, Trace Hernandez, Katie Houghton, Grayson Hoy, Gianna Juarez, Sophia Martinez, Grace Miller, Francisco O'Brien, Benny Padilla, and Mia Robles.
We would also like to recognize students who served as Eucharistic ministers and sacristans, altar servers, or doing the sound system for masses. Please stand when your name is called. Clarissa Alejandre, Jackson Dykesel, Nico Ersig, Elise Gary, Trace Hernandez, Katie Houghton, Grayson Hoy, Gianna Juarez, Angelo Machado, Grace Miller, Francisco O'Brien, Mia Robles, and Ryan Trent.
And I would like to have the two students who earned the Monsignor de Groot Leadership Award in eighth grade, Mia Robles and Grace Miller. We will continue the presentation of awards and scholarships with the Father John C. Mills and Monsignor Cumins Scholarship Awards. There are two scholarships presented every year to the students achieving the highest academic honors of the graduating class. Our valedictorian, that is the student with the highest grade point average for the class of 2020, and the recipient for the Father John C. Mill Scholarship Award is Katie Houghton. Our salutatorian, that is the student with the second highest grade point average for the class of 2020, and the recipient of the Monsignor Cummins Scholarship Award is Benny Padilla. Congratulations to our students of highest academic achievement.
An ongoing tradition at St. Stanislaus Catholic School is for one boy and one girl from the eighth grade class to be chosen to crown the Blessed Mother Mary on the first Friday in May. This year, the young lady and young man chosen for the honor of crowning Mary were Jorge Guerrero and Grace Miller. Congratulations, Grace and Jorge.
The Donna O'Connor Principal's Perseverance Award. This award was first given at our 2011 graduation. The award recipient was decided by the principal, Mrs. Holcraft, and the middle school teachers. The characteristic that we are recognizing and honoring with this award is perseverance, stick-to-itness, just everyday hard work and an overcoming of obstacles at times to achieve success. We also feel like it is important to recognize the longstanding and honored service of our former principal, Mrs. Donna O'Connor. This year's recipient of the Donna O'Connor Principal's Perseverance Award is Gianna Juarez. Congratulations, Gianna, for persevering, working hard, and being successful in your endeavors. The next award is the American Legion Award. Unfortunately, this year, we were not allowed to go to the ceremony that they had. They didn't have it this year. Due to the circumstances. Normally there's a dinner and they honor these students, so these students don't know that they got this award until right now. So the American Legion Award is presented to both a boy and a girl from the eighth grade class who demonstrate high qualities of citizenship, courage, honor, leadership, patriotism, scholarship, and service. The recipients from the graduating class of 2020 are Addison Eberhardt and Evan Lundquist. Congratulations.
Virtues are the foundation of Christian moral activities. The student being recognized this evening as the recipient for the St. Stanislaus Christian Virtue Award is a young man who lives his life every day in reflection of the virtuous life God intended. This student seeks to know and do God's will on a daily basis. The recipient of the Christian Virtue Award this year is Atticus Bray. Congratulations, Atticus, and thank you for showing us the light of Christ in all you do. It's still me. St. Stanislaus Catholic School has been blessed in recent years to receive scholarship money from the Catholic Daughters of America. The scholarships are awarded to students who demonstrate good Christian values and strong academics. Our recipients this year are two eighth graders who appreciate and truly embrace faith, tradition, and excellence of our school. We are very proud to present this year's Catholic Daughters Award to Albert Gonzalez, Grayson Hoy, and Spencer Mortensen. Congratulations, Albert, Grayson, and Spencer.
The Athletic Scholarship Award. The Athletic Scholarship Award is given each year to two student athletes, a boy and a girl, who best represent Christian sportsmanship. In addition to having a competitive spirit, they are supportive of their teammates and respectful to the coaches, their opponents, and the referees. They gracefully accept defeat, and they are humble in victory. The young lady receiving this year's Athletic Scholarship is Sophie Castillon. The young man receiving this year's athletic scholarship is Trace Hernandez. Congratulations, Sophie and Trace. Next are the Central Catholic High School scholarships. So I will say the names of the students, and then I will explain which scholarships you're receiving. So just remain standing until we go on to the next person. The first recipient is Clarissa Alejandre, and she's receiving the Angel Scholarship and a CCHS grant. The next recipient is Sophie Castellon, and Sophie is receiving the James Dovici Memorial Scholarship, the Mission Scholarship, and the Charlotte Skokin Memorial Scholarship. Congratulations. The next recipient is Jorge Guerrero, and he is receiving the Mission Scholarship and the Bishop Stephen Blair Scholarship, and also the CCHS grant. Congratulations. The next recipient is Evan Lundquist, and he is receiving a CCHS grant. Congratulations. The next recipient is Mia Robles, and she's also receiving a CCHS grant. Congratulations. The final recipient is Genesis Placencia Rodriguez, and she is receiving the Mission Scholarship and the Bishop Stephen Blair Scholarship. Congratulations. I'd like to invite Mrs. Miller to come up and announce the Project Go Michael E. Kelly I Am Third Scholarships.
I won't be able to read my notes because I was wondering why it was so dark in here when I came in, and I had my sunglasses on, which have my prescription also. So I am honored to be presenting this award on behalf of Ed and Debbie Kelly. Their son, Michael, is the one that's honored by this award. He died 8 years ago as a junior at Santa Clara University. The I'm Third Project Go scholarship goes to a student who, two students who followed the I'm Third way of life, putting God first, others second, and yourself third. And I'm proud to award those this year on behalf of the Kelly family to William Amari and Grace Miller.
At this time, we will be setting up to show the slideshow, since we did not have a baccalaureate brunch to share that. It'll be shown now, and it'll also be in the video link. And I'd like to just thank the Sams family for working so hard on this for you all to see. So hope you have some tissues. Wish I did.
Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. You spend your days, but they all add up. till my moment comes, I'll say, I did it all. I did it all. I owned every second that this world could give. I saw so many places, the things that I did. There was every broken bone, I swear I lived. I lived.
Thank you all once again for being here, for following guidelines, for making the sacrifices. And as Katie mentioned earlier in her speech, it's difficult to say goodbye to them because we didn't really get a last day with all of you at St. Stanislaus Catholic School. Please know that you will continue to be in our prayers, and we know you're going to do amazing things out there. And as part of saying goodbye, this year we actually say goodbye to two of our teachers as well. So I wanted to bring up, so you could give them a hand, for the years that Ms. Miller has given to us. So would you come up, please? We're going to miss you, Ms. Miller. We're going to miss you. I'm going to miss you personally coming into my office and always making me laugh and supporting me and all of the things that you did, and we wish you the best. And also, today we say goodbye to Ms. Munoz. They were their favorite. Oh, they were your favorite teachers. Oh, they were Miss... They were Father Marian's favorite teacher, so there you go. Thank you, Ms. Munoz, for all the hard work, and we wish you the best, and you will be missed. And so we're going to start now. We just want to thank you all for being here, and we're almost to the end, and it's time for diplomas.
Okay. So it's now that moment that our graduates have been waiting for, the presentation of their diplomas. And just keep in mind, parents, you can't come forward to take photographs, but Miss Alejandra graciously volunteered, and she's a professional photographer. She's going to be taking a photo for you, and we'll get them to you probably via email. So just so you know, you will have that coming. Okay? So, graduates, you are going to, when your name is called, you're going to come up the center aisle, and you're going to stand on the X that's right in front of the table. Your diploma is on the table. Your name is on the outside of the envelope. Please turn around, hold that, and face the audience, and we're gonna say a few words about you.
If you'd like to say hi to your family, through the phone, you can turn to that camera.
Okay, so the live streaming's coming from here. You can look there too, and I know some of you, if you're in a mask, we can't see a smile, but we were given permission if you want to, when you come up, take the mask off when you're up here, and then just put it back when you go back to your seat. Okay, so then we can see your beautiful smiles. Okay. And then you'll come up the center and you'll return down the side to your same pew and go back to your seat and just sit down so the people can see the next person. All right, so we are ready. For having completed the approved course of study as prescribed for the elementary and middle school grades of the Diocese of Stockton and St. Stanislaus Catholic School, diplomas are awarded to the following candidates. Clarissa Alejandre. Clarissa is a very faith-filled young lady. Her faith is at the center of all that she does. This is evident in her many acts of service, whether as a Eucharistic minister, sacristan, or just serving others in our school, parish, or community. She is always ready and willing to help out with a smile on her face. Clarissa is the epitome of the word steward. So Clarissa, continue to let God's light shine through you, and remember Mother Eberhardt. Addison is a kind-hearted young lady. She is always considerate and respectful. She has a quiet, gentle disposition. She is both talented and hardworking in the classroom, on the volleyball court, and on the softball diamond. She is a joy to have in the classroom and on your team. So Addison, remember that love and kindness bless the one who receives them, but they also bless the giver. Continue giving. Congratulations, Addison. Nicola Ersig. Nico has a multitude of talents, both in the classroom and on the soccer field. He is a very bright student who is knowledgeable about many things, including business and politics. He is quick-witted and has a knack for making others laugh. So Nico, remember this quote, because we know what amazing things you are capable of. You don't have to be great to start something. But you have to start something to be great. Congratulations, Nico.
Elise Gary. Elise is a young lady who is always there with a sweet, gentle smile on her face. She is a friend to everyone. She is helpful, energetic, and compassionate. She has a kind, nurturing soul, especially when it comes to animals. She is an avid reader and a gifted student. So Elise, continue to be that ray of sunshine that you are, and you will undoubtedly brighten the world around you. Congratulations, Elise. Albert Gonzalez. Albert is a very centered young man. He has such a strong foundation of faith and values. He is an example to his classmates. He is a gifted student and a valued friend. His many positive qualities were very appreciated by his teachers. So Albert, continue to be a diligent student who is guided by your strong sense of faith and character. Settle for nothing but your best, and the sky's the limit. Congratulations, Albert. Ramon Gonzalez Castaneda. Ramon joined our class in middle school, but based on his interactions with his classmates, it seems as if he's been with us much longer. This can be attributed to his warm, genuine personality. He has a fun sense of humor and is always willing to share a smile or laugh. So Ramon, remember these words. Use your smile to change the world, but never let the world change your smile. Congratulations, Ramon. Jorge Guerrero. Though Jorge did not join our class until middle school, he has added to our class in many ways. He is a gifted student, a kind friend, a talented athlete, a young man of faith, a responsible member of student council, and most of all, an example of respect to his classmates. Jorge, thank you for sharing your gentleness. So Grayson, remember these words. Sometimes it's not strength, but gentleness that cracks the hardest shells. So Grayson, continue to be that quiet leader, the calmness and gentleness that we need in this world. Congratulations, Grayson. Gianna Juarez. Gianna has really blossomed in the last year. She is a conscientious student in her schoolwork and is always willing to lend a helping hand. She is a talented artist who always went above and beyond in her class projects. She is very devout and has a deep love of her faith. So Gianna, keep making the world more beautiful by sharing your gifts and living your faith. Congratulations, Gianna. Sophia Junquero. Sophia is a fun, spirited, and gifted young lady. She is outgoing and well-liked by her peers. She has grown so much in recent years. She has become a confident and responsible student. So continue in the direction you are going, and remember this quote by Audrey Hepburn. Nothing is impossible. The word itself says, I'm possible. Congratulations, Sophia. Evan Lundquist. Evan joined our school community in middle school. He has been a wonderful addition to our classroom. He is not only a gifted student, but he is respectful, responsible, and conscientious in all that he does. He is very giving of his time and talents through Boy Scouts and altar serving. He always conducts himself with the utmost respect for those around him. So Evan, continue to be an example to others in all that you do. Congratulations, Evan. Angelo Machado.
Angelo is a bit of a surprise. What I mean is that when you first meet him, he comes across as the funny guy who's always able to make and congratulations. May God bless you and Mary keep you always. You may move your tassels to the other side, and you have now graduated. We do have one more thing to do, so round of applause. Okay, you may be seated. There is a tradition at St. Stanislaus Catholic School where we recognize another important group of people during the celebration. We have many families who, like their eighth grade students, will be graduating and moving on from St. Stanislaus this year. The graduating eighth grader is our last child attending our school, so we would like to thank them for their longtime support and for the sacrifices they have made in order to bless their children with the gift of a Catholic education. We ask parents to please stand when your family name is read. But please hold your applause until the end. Normally we would have the students bring you a flower at this time, but we're trying to eliminate the crossing of paths. So what we're asking the students to do is when they are dismissed by the teachers, they will take a flower from the vase that's in the pews behind the students, between the students and the parents. You'll see them. Teachers will be there to help you. And if your name is called, just take a flower and you'll present it to your parents as you process out together. Okay, so I'd like to read the names of the parents that are also graduating with their former eighth grader. And these families are the Amari family, so please stand. The Castellon family. The Eberhardt family. The Ersig family. The Gary family. The Gonzalez-Castaneda family. The Gonzalez family. The Houghton family. The Hoy family. The Lundquist family. The Machado family. The Martinez family. The Marino family. The Miller family. The O'Brien family. The Robles family. The Placencia Rodriguez family. The Sams family. And the Trent family. Okay, so we're ready to process out. That's it for the evening. Again, there's gonna be a teacher on each aisle directing students, so I'll have you stand up. We're gonna start the music. And the students are going to be dismissed one at a time from each aisle, and they will pick their parents up on the way out because you should be directly behind your students pretty much. And again, if you're graduating, if you're the last one in your family, take a flower from the vase. They're behind Mia, Francisco, and Ryan. The flowers are there, and present it to your family. Congratulations, and we'll be in touch about information regarding awards and things mailed out and stuff. I'll be sending an email, so keep your eyes out for that. Thank you all.
And please rise for the final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our graduation ceremony is ended. Let us all go in the peace and the love of Christ.